Thank you so much for being here to celebrate with us. That is the sole intent of this assembly, if you haven't noticed already. But the sole intent of this assembly is to celebrate the great work that's done by all the people in this room. You know, so many times I talk to you all students of Syringa Middle School, about it starts with you. So many times I talk to you about that. We start the year with that. And we say that the school year is going to be as good as you make it. It's going to be as good as you students make it in this room. You know, Syringa Middle School has some great opportunities for you all as students. They have some great opportunities that are supplied to you by great teachers. You know, and two of those opportunities we're here to celebrate today. If you haven't noticed, there's a few important dignitaries that are also with us today to join in that celebration. So the very first thing that I'd like to do, I'd like to start off to my left-hand side and introduce all of the dignitaries, these very important guests that we have here today that are going to join in with us within this celebration. As I go through these people, these introductions, please do your best to hold your applause, and we'll make sure we give them one big round of applause when we're done with this. The first guest that we have with us today is Miss Debbie Olson, who is our CEA president for Caldwell School District. That'll work. Next up is Penny Sear, Idaho Education Association president. Also with us today is Brenda Miller, the Northwest Professional Educators Regional Director. Next with us today is the great Jody Mills, Superintendent of Caldwell School District. Also joining us is Tom Dell, County Commissioner. Linda Clark from the State Board of Education. Public Representative Senator Jim Rice. Also the proud parent of Syringa students. Past Syringa students. The next representative is Representative Greg Cheney. And last but not least is our Superintendent of Public Instruction, Sherry Ibarra. Before we start this assembly, I'd just like to talk about the two programs that we have brought everybody into Syringa today to discuss. The first one, as we started this year, we said that it was very, very important. We felt like a staff that it was very, very important for students to get involved with what we do after school. We have some great opportunities, some great learning opportunities for you that take place inside of this school during the school hours. We also have several teachers that have done a phenomenal job to supply opportunities, and not only athletic opportunities, not only musical opportunities, but opportunities that explore all different academic areas, and those opportunities exist after school. And we said, hey, let's get involved. As a student body, let's get involved. And we said, let's celebrate that. The students that get involved, let's celebrate that, and let's create a movement. My hope is that we can be out there on the blacktop, we can be in the cafeteria, we can be in the classroom, and we can see all the Syringa shirts around. And we can be in groups of friends, and we can see our four or five friends that they have these shirts, they're involved in something. And we want to create that movement, and we want to be there with them and get involved. That's the first thing that we're going to talk about this morning. The second thing that we're going to talk about is college awareness. Once again, as a staff, we felt like it was very important that you are immersed with the language of post-secondary opportunities. What that means for you, those opportunities that exist, and what success that will lead you to. Okay, so those two things we feel like as a staff and as a school and as a district and as a state are very important for you as kids. Once again, this school is going to be as great as you make it. Get involved in stuff, be planning for college, okay? Two things that we'll do before we start this assembly. The first thing is we're going to do our scholar acrostic. I know everybody from Syringa knows exactly what that scholar acrostic, but for guests, this is something that we do on a daily basis to get our day started. Also, every assembly that we go through, we start with that scholar acrostic. We try to say it, and we try to live it. Well, then, after we're done with the scholar acrostic, I'll pass it over to Mrs. Foreman. She's prepared our great choir group. They're going to lead us with the they're going to perform the national anthem for us today. So at this time, I'd like everybody to stand for that scholar acrostic. Let's be loud and proud. S. C. H. O. Thank you very much. Please stay standing. Our national anthem.
Thank you for giving us this opportunity. This is the sixth grade choir, the seventh and eighth grade girls choir, and the seventh and eighth grade boys choir.
Have to give you the eyes up cue. Sam West, we need you in the office right now. Sam West, if you're in the gym, please report. Thank you. Thank you, Sam. Appreciate that. At this time, I'm going to pass it over to Miss Jody Mills, Superintendent Caldwell School District. She has a few words to say and an introduction to make. Miss Jody Mills.
Well, good morning, good morning, good morning. How are you all doing this morning? Didn't quite get that. How are you doing? Excellent. So I have one thing we need to do before we get on with this assembly. First of all, I cannot tell you how incredibly proud I am of you right now. As I stand in front of you with the folks to my left and the way you are so respectful of audiences and of visitors to your school, I think first of all you all need to stand up and give yourselves an applause. Please do that. The second thing I'd like to recognize is if you are a staff member here at Syringa, would you please stand? Let's give them an applause. Now, let's get on with why we're here. There's a recognition right now of not only you as a member of the Syringa Panthers, but as where you are right now in your educational journey. And it is so impactful for me to walk into a building and hear you say the words that you said to start up this assembly, that we know we're on the right track. And we know that whatever your future holds, that you will be prepared, and you will encounter some hurdles as you go throughout this journey, but know that the folks to your right and the folks to your left and the folks in front of you and behind you are encouraging you every step of the way, because the last thing you spoke of is success. And we believe, I believe, that every single one of you in here have the ability to be successful in your world. And that's what we're going to strive through for the remaining time you have here with the Caldwell School District. So with that, I have the great privilege of turning the mic over to Superintendent Ybarra. She's with us today to make a recognition of what you have done and what you stand for, not only as a person, but as a class and as a school. So if you would please help me welcome Superintendent Ybarra to the mic.
Good morning. Bienvenidos. It is a pleasure to be here with you this morning. I want to say one thing before I get started. I am so proud of you. The reason I do this job, don't forget this, the reason I do this job is because of each and every one of you in here today. No other reason. You make me proud, and the respect that you have shown today is unbelievable. I am very proud of you, so thank you for having me here. I understand you're here today to talk about getting involved. I've heard your principal and your superintendent talk to you about that, planning for your future, whether it's college or career, correct?
Yes.
Planning for your future is a big deal. You don't let anybody discourage you. You don't let anybody stop you. And you don't let anybody make you quit. You make your life mean something. And I'm here because I believe in you. And I know that your teachers believe in you as well. But I have a secret. I'm here today for something else. Wait a minute, speaking of your teachers, I hear you have some awesome teachers in the Caldwell School District. Is that true?
Yes!
I don't think I heard you loud enough. Is that true?
Yes!
That's what I expect out of you. Well, you know what? Here's my secret. One of your teachers here today has been named Teacher of the Year. That is a huge deal because there is only one in the whole state of Idaho, and it's from the Caldwell School District. So this is really important and really exciting because this teacher believes in you like I do a lot, and that's a gift. This teacher's been here for 15 years. She believes in all of her students. She volunteers her time outside of the classroom to ensure that students like you are getting all the support that they need. She believes in her community. She believes in all of her students, no matter where they come from, no matter how rich, no matter how poor, that you have the best education in life, and that you're engaged. She really supports STEM because she knows that's how we build relationships and how we level the playing field for you to get the best opportunities and have the best future with the best jobs. She is first class when it comes to connecting with students and families. I know this because when I read her biography, it talked about one of her students. And while this student was on a family vacation to the Arches National Park, the student said, "Oh, I wish my teacher were here. I've got to show her this." So instead, the student snapped the picture and sent it along to the teacher because the teacher couldn't be there. What middle school student thinks of their teacher when they're on a family vacation and they don't have to be here at school? That tells me a lot. Her students, like you, they love her. They think of her all the time. I could not help but be so impressed because when I read her biography, she's passionate, she's a leader, she's talented, but most importantly, it's teachers like her that are going to show you the way. They're going to give you the gift that you need to keep you engaged, protect your future, and show you endless love and support. Because you are our future leaders, and you are going to be in your future forever. From the words of her fellow teachers and colleagues and parents and her numerous supporters, she is a blessing, and you are so lucky to have her. Okay, enough talk about her. Are you ready for me to tell you who she is?
Yeah.
Say it again, are you ready for me to tell you who she is? I am so humbled and so honored to introduce to you your very own teacher, Miss Melyssa Ferro, the Idaho Teacher of the Year.
I will tell you, first of all, that one of my favorite quotes in the entire world is from Sir Isaac Newton. Sir Isaac Newton said, "I would not have seen as far if I had not stood on the shoulders of giants." And to me, the people that I work with, the people that just came and hugged me that are my family, my support system and my administration, you guys are the giants that let me see as far as I do. All the crazy things that I'm able to do for the kids at Syringa and the families of Syringa are because so far nobody's told me no. Every time I go to my administration or to my fellow teachers and I say, I've got this great plan, you guys want to get on board? You guys all jump on board with me. Students, you guys get on board with my crazy plans. Teachers, you do too. So really this award speaks more about Caldwell and who we are as a school district than anything personally about me. But I want to encourage you all to get involved with science and technology and engineering and mathematics. These are the jobs of the future. These are the skills that are going to help you get jobs in the future to help you go on to college. So get involved. Come join robotics. Come join our Florida field trip. Come join our science and academic bowl. All of these fantastic opportunities for you to get involved and to get a little science in your life. Thank you.
Check.